Okay, so now I'm going to walk you through a simple postpartum Pilates routine that involves working specifically on your pelvic floor rather than your, and your core, your lower core, rather than just your abs, which is totally different. So we want to strengthen those muscles that allow the baby to come out. We want to strengthen the muscles so that way it can come back together and work on that. So this will be a simple routine that you can do with your baby at home. You're gonna lie on your back, and you first are going to do what's called just activating the pelvic floor muscles, which I talked about in the previous video. So you're gonna want to put your triangle on top, make it nice and level. You'll take a couple breaths in. Exhale, and as you exhale, you want to just engage those muscles down at the bottom first. Pull up in, and try to bring them into here and hold. And that's going to get you activated. So you'll feel those muscles kind of pull up and come in, and then try to bring them in right here. You can do the best you can to keep your shoulders down and keep this area relaxed, because we're focusing right here and keeping this triangle flat or neutral spine is what that's called. From there, you're going to want to do probably anywhere from 5 to 10. It depends on how much time you have to do that. So I would start with 5 just to get going. Then you could do what's called pelvic tilts. And so that's where you're going to use your pelvic floor, and you're going to activate on the exhale, pull those muscles in, pull your abs in, and then allow your pelvis to tilt up this way. Okay, so that's called a pelvic tilt. So from there, let's say you've done 7 of your activators, then you're going to want to breathe in, exhale, engage the muscles, your pelvic floor muscles, pull them in, pull this area in, hold, and tilt up. That gives you that extra pull. Hold it for maybe 1, 2, 3, and exhale, put that pelvis back down. You want to probably do about 10 of those to really get control of your pelvis and learning to release your pelvic floor muscles and then activate and pull them back up. From there, then you can go into your bridge, which is very simple. You're going to breathe in, exhale, engage your pelvic floor muscles, pull your core in, tilt your pelvis up, and then push up, okay? Now, depending on how your knees are gonna let you go, it doesn't really matter too much the height. Go to where you're comfortable. I have difficult knees from running, so I can't go up too high, but you're gonna wanna hold, and take an inhale at the top. As you exhale, you're gonna wanna push your spine down like it's a chain falling down on the ground. Slowly, one piece at a time. And then exhale, finish the exhale, and then you go back to neutral spine, and you're gonna wanna release those muscles, especially your pelvic floor. Really wanna release them here. Then you inhale, exhale, pull your pelvic floor in, core tilt, push up, hold, inhale, exhale. As you exhale, allow it to come down, and all the way down to neutral spine. 10 of those is really good, because it's going to start activating your glutes. The important thing that you want to remember when you're contracting your pelvic floor muscles, do not allow your glutes or your legs to contract at all. These need to stay super loose. If this is only your pelvic floor muscles, which are more in the center bottom, not back here. Strength back here is important, but not when you're trying to rebuild the strength of your pelvic floor. So once you get done with your bridges, I'll do one with you. We can inhale, exhale, squeeze in, come up. From here, a more advanced move that you can do is you're going to want to lift a leg and hold. Now, you can see that one hip falls. You don't want to do that the best you can. You want to really push up, and this glute is going to start activating and hold. That's going to start strengthening your glutes. If you can hold for a minute, then you can come down, push that side back up. That's going to get you started, basically, with your slowly increasing your strength. Those 3 moves are really good to do. If you lift up one leg and you notice that your pelvic area, the bones,
don't feel strong enough to hold that displacement of weight, then don't do it. I know for me, it took some time before my bones felt like they could hold that, and I could feel it, like some soreness in there. So then you don't want to do that yet. You want to just keep working on your pelvic floor, and you want to work on those pelvic tilts so you gain control of your pelvic floor and your core, and then you learn how to relax and let it all go. And really push it up and down, and this is all from muscle memory, connecting your mind to your muscles. And as soon as you really develop that connection, then as we get into more movements and things like that, then you're gonna feel a lot better and it's gonna be a lot easier.